to show you how to access account balances quickly using the combination of pivot tables and VLOOKUP. I have a table of data here, and there are numbers of different accounts, and there's amounts for each account that need to be totaled. The first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to create a table out of this data. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to click in the middle of my cells here. I'm going to go to the Insert tab, and I'm going to select Table. And I'm going to make sure I have my table has headings clicked as well. And I say OK. And so now what I'm going to do with this table is I'm going to click in the middle of this table, and I'm going to go Insert, and I'm going to select Pivot Table. And so this is going to put it on another sheet, which is fine. And then I'm going to say OK. And so now, in this pivot table, the only thing I want to have is I'm going to have the account numbers, and so I'm going to put those in the rows. And the amounts that I would like to have summed up, the amounts is what I would like to have totaled up, so I'm going to put in sum amounts. And you have those next to that. And this is a pretty straightforward pivot table. Now, the theory is that if you were doing this, you wouldn't have a small set of data here. You'd probably have hundreds of accounts and maybe even thousands, and you wouldn't want to have to scroll through them to find the one that you need. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up to the cell here. Now, normally people have told me that if I go equals and reference this cell here, I'm going to get a get pivot data formula in there. But I'm just getting A4, which works for me. And so I'm going to go and I'm going to click and drag this down. So now we have all the account numbers here. And let's go in the next cell to it. And let's go equals. And let's link to the data and the sales amount. And then we're going to press enter. And then we're going to drag this down as well. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to select both these. And I'm going to name this range account totals. So I'm going to go ACC and TOT and press enter. Now I'm going to create another sheet where I can just have the account numbers and the account balances show up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make this larger so you can see it. And so in B1 I'm going to put account, and in C1 I'm going to put balances. Okay, now the balances can be very large, so I'm going to increase this by a certain amount here. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a drop down list of all the account numbers here. So I'm going to my data tab, and I'm selecting data validation, and I'm selecting list. And so the source of my list is my data that I've gotten from the pivot table. So I'm going back to sheet 2, and I'm going to select all this data of the account numbers here. And then I'm going to click this, and then I'm going to say OK. Okay, so now if you drop this down, you can access any account number that you like. So what I'm going to do here is in the other cell is I'm going to use VLOOKUP to figure out what the balances are. So I'm going to use the FX key, and I'm going to select VLOOKUP, and I'm going to say OK. And so what I'd like to look up is the value that's in B2. I'm going to use the table array, which was the ACCTOT that I created. And the column index is, I want to get the data from the second column, which is the balance. And that should be fine. And so we say OK. And so now you can drop down. You could basically, if you had a phone call, if you had somebody from the other department that was looking to see what the balance was for any account number, you could instantly bring it up. Now, the problem with this, though, is you're thinking, well, that's nice at any particular time, but what happens if some data is entered? So let me select this one right here, because I know it's at the bottom of my table. And so the balance right now is 823. So let's go to sheet 1, and I'm going down to the bottom of this table, And what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag it down so I get the formatting there, and it changes it to 371 or 71. So I'm going to change it back to 70, and then I'm going to drag everything else down here. And then I'm going to make something dramatic. So it was 823. So let me enter 1,000 here. And then what I'm going to do is I am going to drag my my date value down here. I'm on the data tab. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and I'm going to refresh all. And so now let's go look at our pivot table. And our pivot table for 30 is 1823. And so now let's go back to sheet three, which is our values. So the account value is, it's all up to date. So it's 030170 and it's 1823, which is the new balance. So once again, you're able to pull up any balance that you want at any as quick as you'd like. This is how you create a quick access balance sheet from pivot tables in VLOOKUP. Please subscribe.